How is it going, everybody? Thank you all for joining me for another episode of Jay Plays. I am Jay Wright, and today we are taking on Death's Door. Well, we are continuing our journey with Death's Door. Last we left, we killed Betsy or Bezzy, the beast atop the summit, and that pretty much gave us all our collections for Giant Soul, so I'm not actually sure what we need to do next. I'm just going to kind of talk to everybody and feel the way forward out. Yeah, I already read that. So, nothing new with these individuals. Definitely increase something. We have 1568, so we can go ahead and finish haste. It actually doesn't seem like a bad idea. Yeah, let's just go ahead and max that out. And he is incredibly fast. Oh, Kuro is still here, so maybe that's our way forward. You did it. You are a much stronger Reaper than I. I could have never taken down those giant souls alone. It is time. At long last. Let us force this door open, fledgling, and finish our assignments. Ooh. And now to the other side. At that pace, it may take you a minute. You gotta upgrade your speed like we did. This is it. This is the place beyond, where no life is to be seen. Hello? So there is a Grim Reaper. Met him quite a few times. Are you Death? I thought the tales of the original Reaper were just the mad ramblings of the Free Crows. Yeah, well, I guess that's me. So, if you didn't know I was real, that means you're not here to rescue me, huh? No. I'm sorry. We're here for another purpose. In fact, you might be able to help us. Wow. Rude. But alright, I mean, what's a few more minutes after several centuries? So, why are you here? Actually, how did you even get here? We seek souls that have passed through Death's your door. We are service-bound Reapers. We require those souls to finish our task and restore our stature with the Commission. Otherwise, we will die. Oh. Awkward. If you are looking for a soul here, then you're out of luck. Any non-corporeal souls that pass through the door are absorbed into the aether. Soul energy has to be recycled to create new life. That's why my job was so important. Not that the living didn't hate me for it. Alright, so in their world, reincarnation is real. I used to go around reaping souls myself, then pick them up and take them beyond the veil. But it was so depressing. Not for the souls, they don't care, but for the living ones they left behind. I wish I could let them know dying isn't scary, it's just the cycle of life. Thing is, over the vastness of time, I got very tired of that cycle. But then one day, a strange being came to me with a proposition. This being could create portals, doors, to any place or world. They offered to outsource the collection of souls to an automated system using one of their doors. While it was open, it would draw on the souls of the dead. A lighthouse on the shores of the Aether, if you will. In return for this, they asked for their lives to be extended. Well, actually, they asked for immortality, but that's impossible. If souls stick around too long past their expiry date, then with nothing left to tie them to mortality, they decay into demonic forms. All life must end. Well, eventually. So while I kicked back, several generations of these self-proclaimed Lord of Dords came and went, enjoying their unnaturally long lives. Each one agreeing, in the end, to submit to the limitations of life and go willingly into the Aether. Till one didn't. Which brings us to your current Lord of Doors. Towards the end of what should have been their lifespan, your Lord betrayed our long-standing agreement. They said there had been some kind of incident, that the door had malfunctioned and needed to be remade anew. For the door to be reconstructed, it would require the touch of death to link the door to the Aether. But after this new door was created and opened, the Lord kicked me inside and sealed it shut. No way for me to escape. No way for stray souls to pass on to the Aether. No death among the living. I've been here. Alone. Ever since. But my assigned soul. It must be here. It has to be here. I tracked it to this door. It must have entered here somehow. Are you sure you haven't seen it? Sorry, guy. If a soul comes in here without a body, it disappears into the Aether. Sooner or later, everything that begins has to end. So, there's no hope. It must still be here somewhere. No. I wasted so many years searching for that soul. Decades. Centuries. I refuse to die. Uh-oh. I sense you're a little bit past your best before date. Oh boy. Well, that's a cool way to intro the final boss. Aren't you like the most powerful thing there is, Death? What the hell? Why would you just disappear on us? I did not expect this to be us going straight into the final fight, but here we are. Oh, we can send those as... Okay. Oh, man. It sucks. I get why he's upset, though. He's basically saying he wasted his... Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, whoa. That's a cool attack. He wasted his entire life. Focus on this one task just to find out that it was a waste, and now he's missed out on life. Completely, so I can see why he's upset. I got that. Oh, boy. That is a really cool attack. I want that attack. Don't know what he's about to do. We're going to avoid these as best we can. Oh, boy. Throw that at him, maybe. Nope. Move out the way. Whoop. Move out the way. Whoa, God. This is a really cool area to do battle in, too. Oh, boy. Come on. We got to do more damage than this. We are hurting. Ah. Get some burning going on him. Oh, here we go. Get out the way. Take that. Whoop. Get out of his way. Here we go. Here we go. Ah, you suck for that. This may not be the one. No, wrong attack. Oh God. Roll out. What the hell just hit me? Oh, it was one of his crow friends. I mean, death is right here in the room. He could just, you know, snap us back. But, you know, we can definitely see what the lesson is here in this whole game, what the theme is of, you know, not fearing death and just kind of accepting it as part of life. And yeah, don't waste it. Don't waste the gift, as this big crow is unfortunately a victim to. Oh my gosh, I gotta stop staying there for that. It seems like such a simple attack to dodge, and yet. Ah! Like some matador type stuff. Ah! Get that. Get that. Ah. Take that. Where's he at? Oh boy. Yeah, he's got a new attack coming in, looks like. Oh, whoa. Are we getting sucked towards that? We definitely are. Ah. Oh boy, missed that. There we go. Oh boy, get out the way. Here we go. Throw it at him. Nice dodge. Throw that at him. Ah. Dodge. Whoop. Ah, I want to send that at him, but. Oh, almost stood there too long for that. Dodge. Not sure what I did wrong there, but I did it. Come on. Are you kidding me? I'm a little upset at myself for that one. That, I don't feel like I should have died there. Hate the birds. Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Oh my gosh, thank you. That chain, you have to use that chain to get close to him real quick. Otherwise, you'll be running around too much and eventually he will kill you with one of his attacks. Even though they don't seem like they'd be that hard to dodge. They can suck. How did he get out the door? I can't tell you how long it's been since I felt a fresh breeze on my face or saw, well, anything. You never appreciate something until it's gone, do you? I saw a lot of that in my job. But until your Lord of Doors locked me up, I never thought it'd apply to me. I'm sorry about your big feathered friend back there. It's always hard for the living to let go of the dead. Not really much of a friend, actually. Even more of a rough one, having to reap him yourself. I can sort of understand that feeling. Even if it wasn't your intention, you'd have done me a huge favor here, Crow. But this isn't over quite yet. Because while the door has been destroyed, my power is unfortunately still trapped in its remains. Forging the door required a piece of my own soul, and I need it back before I can do my job again. That means if we want to end this cycle, someone else has to take down the Lord of Doors. Have you guessed who yet? I won't be making any more deals again, that's for sure. Head back to your office and reap your boss's soul, Crow. And remember, death is on your side. Wanna make a deal? Rock, paper, scissors to see who has to go back and do this battle? Head back to your office and I'll be lurking around until the job is done. Alright, well, we can either go straight to fighting El Capitan, or we can try and collect some more of these secrets. It'd be nice to have one more health bar, one more magic, so I will search around for a little bit and see if I can find more of these shrines. I will see if I can find more. Oh! This is not what I meant to do. This was an accident. I was trying to teleport to another area. Crap. My fellow crows, we have arrived at a moment foretold long ago. Today, death's door has been opened, and death themselves has been freed once more into the world. Fear not, for this is not the end of days, but the beginning of a bright new future. I just noticed that Crow has four eyes. The forces of life, and not by his glasses, I mean literally four eyes. The forces of life and death have been unnaturally thrown into chaos for 1,000 years, and we crows played a hand in that. We must right our wrongs. Our desk looks so cool in the background. We must accept our fates. We must reject those who lead us into a future with no hope. It is time for the Lord of Doors' reign to end, and for us to return to a natural life cycle. Even as our world teeters on the edge of oblivion, souls like these forest spirits still manage to emerge through the cracks. Soon a new age will begin, and the world will teem with new life. For that to happen, the final hours of this foretold day must play out as ordained. The crow that freed death will have to end the Lord of Doors' reign. I'd like to hear the rest of that prophecy just in case it ends in death of us as well. Alright, well, that means we still have time to go and explore, because we have to go through that door, I'm guessing. I have no doubt that you will complete your task, old friend. Have faith in yourself. Do we have enough souls to do anything? No, we do not. Not even a little bit. Ha! So I guess we're all gonna be out of our jobs soon. Finally, I can be free of the rat race. I never wanted to be a reaper, you know? It was just a matter of necessity. I wonder what I could do next. I guess endless possibilities lie ahead. Of course, it all depends on you finishing your job without getting killed in the process. But I reckon you'll get it done, kid. Why is nobody gearing up to help us? He has a sword. He can go in there, too. I know it seems the world is ending, but I really hope I can find a new job after all this. I honestly just love typing. The feel of the keys on my feathers. The clicking and clacking as I push them down. Look at me getting carried away. Go on. You'd best finish clearing this mess up. I have a resume to write. Nobody's looking forward to that. I feel like my whole world is crumbling beneath my feet, but somehow, I also feel hopeful for the first time in... Actually, I think this is the first time I felt hope. Maybe I won't have to work so hard anymore. Cheers to that. Who are you? Ball Plart, head of security. That's funny. All this death and rebirth is a daunting prospect, but I think everyone here is sick of what this world has become. A new world. A new start. I wonder if there will be new TV shows, too. Yeah, you gotta catch that new episode of Loki. Alright, so let's go back to Deke Dark Dungeon. That's a dungeon. Okay, so... clearly we need to be over there somehow. I don't know how to end up over there, though. That is the dilemma we are currently facing, but there is an area that we have not explored. How do we get over there? Aha! Here we go. Here's an area we haven't been. Knew we'd find one eventually. Just took a matter of time. I need something to hit. Mind if I get some health off of you? Thank you. Oh, Jesus. Okay. I don't even want health. I just meant a bomb. Right, come on, shrine. Oh wait. Oh, we gotta move a lot faster. Okay. Try this again, shall we? Come on. One more. Ah! One more. Oh, we got it just in the nick of time. And shrine. Looks like another health one. This leaves us with 6 more to find. That's a lot. Let's keep searching. You know what? I think the shrine is right here. Which means we need to get up on that wall, come down here, and then drop down there. But how do we get up on that wall is the question. Okay, so I think we did it. We fall down here, and boom. Woo, we did it. I thought I'd been over here before. I don't think I paid attention to it before because I thought I'd already got it, but clearly we have not. That puts us at 5 more left to find. All right, so we can do the... All right, sewer grate. I've heard there's a secret through a sewer pipe in the overgrown ruins. You gotta find a sewer pipe in the overgrown ruins. Frog King flooded the lands to the east. Many old structures have become inaccessible. One such structure can still be reached by firing an arrow into the distance through a stone arch. Okay, need to write that down. And then there's a sewer not far from here that might lead to treasure. Although if there's no treasure in there, don't blame me. It is a sewer after all. Alright, that's all he's got. Okay, so I think we have all five clues. We have a, no, that's not true. We only have 4. We have the flooded ruins. We gotta fire an arrow through. The stray bull carriage. The sewer grain that we have to fall in the overgrown ruins. And then a sewer nearby, near the stranded sailor somewhere. That's the 4 we have, so we may actually be missing one more. Okay, so I completely forgot about this secret that we had left over here undone. I just happened to fall down the hole, but, you gotta be quick with this one. So we gotta throw this over here, jump over here, jump over, come on. Jump over here, and just in the nick of time, cool. So this must be the sewer that the Jefferson guy was talking about. Right, forgot we never fought the arrow guy. Let's get it done. Oh. Come on. I thought this one would have some kind of arrow powers, but it seems like it's got general powers. Come on. Oh, it's got the fire powers. Oh! That sucks. Oh my, I can't believe I rolled off the other side. Are you kidding me? You know what? I think this one just has everybody's powers. Now that I'm really observing what's going on, it's got every single one we fought before ability, which sucks. Yeah, I saw it. I just wanted more attacks. I was being greedy. Oh, whoa, that was a dangerous one. Okay, there we go. There we go. Woo, last one. A silent servant has been vanquished in soul power. Holding your arrow spell for longer will now charge your shot and cause more damage. It's something, I guess. We'll take it. That was nice. May have forgotten to explore this area over here. Excuse me. What is over here? Whole new area. Okay, you found an old compass. It occasionally twitches and turns off its own turns of its own whims. It's clearly very old. Perhaps the magnetism inside has mostly worn away. Seems to be working just fine to me. Have we or have we not been over here? Because the fires are lit. Oh, yeah, okay. No, we've been in this area before. We just never got the compass, I guess. Okay, so here's an archway. Let's see if it is very, that's very cool. That's really cool. I love the use of the sailor as a like a hub for information. Really, really cool. And that brings us to 4 more shrines to find. Four more to go. Well, real quick, there is this over here, some souls. Right now, what we're looking for is, I couldn't find what we were missing in the overgrown ruins, so I decided to go back to the sailor, and he gave us a clue that somewhere in this castle there's a hollowed out wall in a key-shaped alcove, so that is what I'm searching for now. Oh, snap, we got over here. Okay, are we supposed to be able to do this? Well, okay then. That was a lucky pull right there. Oh, beautiful, now we are down to 3. 3 more to go, y'all. Oh my gosh. One more for the magic. Okay, here we go. 3 more. 3 beautiful more. And they're probably at those ruins. I have no idea where they're at in those ruins, though. Okay, so I returned to the sailor, and he said that we should return to the lands that we entered these place at. With our newfound abilities, we should be able to find something treasure wise. And I'm seeing we can cross over here like this into a new area. Okay. Collectible. Really want more of a shrine, but sure. You found a makeshift soul key. I wonder who made this. I love that they're all just kind of huddled around it watching it. There's some weird creatures. Still need a shrine, though. Still need that shrine. Alright, y'all, I'm not even gonna lie. I had to get some help here in figuring out this sewer location because we are 2 hours and 13 minutes into recording, and I've been up, down, left, right, diagonal, across, underneath this entire map, and I could not locate this secret pipe to save my life. And it turns out it was right in front of me the entire time. It makes use of an attack that I haven't done before. I'm not really sure when I would have known to do this other than looking up a guide, but apparently it's right here in front of us. These little things that I've been saying are teleporters are not teleporters. You can actually smash them. So it looks like it's a go, and then I screwed that up. Let me try that again. So we're supposed to like roll forward and do an attack, and then boom, you can kind of, as you can see, you can flip it and you end up on the other side. But we've never done that before. That was never revealed to us. I don't know how I would have known that without looking up. But anyway, yeah, here we are. And this should lead us to, hopefully, a shrine. Yeah, would have never known this. So we can start using that attack in multiple areas because I've seen a few of these. Yep, here we go. And then there were two shrines left. I am so disappointed in myself for not, I guess, figuring that out. I just wish there would have been some clue or hint that we could do that. I mean, I knew that we could do that attack. I just didn't know that we could do it on those particular items. And I don't know when I would have figured that out. But because we have gone so far into recording, I am going to go ahead and stop here for the night. And then we will pick this back up the day after tomorrow, because Sunday we have off, obviously. So pick this up the day after tomorrow, and that should be actually our final day of Death's Door, unless there's something crazy ahead. We'll go and get these last two shrines, and then we will go ahead and tackle the final boss, and that'll complete our playthrough. So super excited to take on the Lord of Doors, but also just to see how this all wraps up. Hopefully you'll be joining me for that last adventure. I mean, if you made it this far, you might as well go ahead and complete the adventure, right? So I want to thank you all so much for joining me for this episode of Jay Plays. I am Jay Wright, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Deuces.